Okay, so differential mode is the second measurement it can be in. Starts off with your same oppa that you had before, but this time we're looking at the difference of the inputs. So that means we must use both inputs. Inverting mode simply inverts, differential looks at the difference. So one type of mode uses one input, the other type of mode uses both inputs. So this time we use both inputs. Okay, so bear with me this time. You've got your op amp in the middle, your negative and positive terminals. You've got your VS, your plus VS, and your minus VS. And you've still got your output, which is still the same. All these things haven't changed. You're still going to have one input, and notice it's going to be the slightly longer one of the two. It's on top. And you're still going to have your feedback resistor, which is still going over the top here and feeding back in after the op amp. So that bit's still the same. So that bit is still RF, this is still R1, and this is still V1 with the ground along the bottom. 0 volts, and that's still V1 here. Now, it's a differential op amp, so you need to use more than one input. So you're going to have your second V2. This time, you're going to have another resistor on here. And this one is going to be called R4. And you're going to have a feedback. Its kind of feedback goes down like this. And that's called R3. And that's V2. Now, in the exam, you're not going to have to come up with this from scratch. You will be given most of it, or you'll be given bits and bobs of it, and you have to try and make up the whole circuit. Okay? I'll just give you a chance to copy that out. This one's slightly different. What was the gain for the inverting amplifier? How did we work out the gain? Right, gain in general terms, gain doesn't need a sign. Okay, it's just how much is it bigger by? It doesn't nearly need a sign. So, what is the gain of an inverting amplifier, Robert? I gave you just a couple of minutes ago. What is the gain of the formula? Yep.
V over V amp.
In terms of resistors?
Sorry, over R1.
And it doesn't need a negative because it's just a gain, so it's just RF over R1. Mm-hmm. What? I know, but in terms of gain, you had a minus on the board, Dylan. But in terms of gain itself, it's not a plus, no, it is a negative. Just.
Sorry, you said gain is RF.
For this differential amplifier to operate correctly, then we need to make sure that the gain for V1 is the same for V2. They balance each other out. So, if the gain was equal to RF over R1, then we must make sure that is the same as R3 over R4. That must happen. If that doesn't happen, this is not a differential op-amp. Okay? This must be the case. Right? So this must be. If it's not, then it's not a differential op-amp. It's not a differential mode op-amp. It is just an op-amp that's been cranked up the wrong way. So you must have those resistors equal to one another in that arrangement for this to happen. If that is the case, then the formula for a differential op-amp is just like it means, you're amplifying the difference. So the difference would be V2 minus V1. So you make that bigger by multiplying it by RF over R1. So the output from a differential op-amp is equal to, so V out is equal to the difference, so V2 minus V1, times RF over R1. That is your differential op-amp formula which you're given in the exam. Now, if your RF over R1 is equal to your R3 over R4, then that can be used as well.
Is that a tier of plus?
Yeah. Where? F. Is that T or a plus?
Yes.
V2 minus V1, and then you multiply that by the gain. Okay? Right. That is a differential mode op-amp.